Fatma to deliver her lecture on radiological correlates of clinical severity in COVID. Please, Dr. Jaleel Fatma.
Thank you, Chairperson, and I thank the organizers, Dr. Jaleel Fatma, Dr. Jaleel Fatma, and all others for inviting me to this prestigious conference and this stage to talk upon a very interesting topic of clinical interest, radiological correlates of clinical severity in COVID-19 patients. So, since back 2019, when the world faced the outbreak of coronavirus disease, the patients of acute respiratory distress syndrome started coming, and we saw a panorama of all the drugs which came into the attention once after the other. And in the second wave, when we added some more, we deleted some of the drugs, we acquired some of the treatment strategies, and we left some, and we added some of the investigative methods also. Initially, the world was not prepared, but rapidly we learned several things over these 2 years, and still we are learning. We are, as of now, we are better equipped than 2019, better knowledge of pathogenesis and more experience with better scientific evidence. But some of the truths are there: mask, social distancing, and hand washing will remain with us forever. So introducing the COVID-19, the clinical picture is similar to other type of coronavirus pneumonia. The treatment options vary depending upon the severity of the patient's condition. The severe and critical cases may have a poor prognosis. However, the diagnosis of most important presentation, that is pneumonia, may only be dependent on the history, because there are constraints in the clinical examination. We cannot auscultate the patient. So in detection of the COVID-19, CT scan has been acquired as an imaging or investigating tool. In the detection of COVID-19, CT is superior to chest radiography, as some of the small lesions are not visible on the chest radiographs. The patient's clinical presentations may vary. Asymptomatic carriers may be there. The patients requiring assisted ventilatory support also may be there. And we have seen a spectrum of clinical severity in these patients. So clinical presentation in the prodromal phase includes fever, dry cough, and nales, we all know. And some of the patients may be remaining largely asymptomatic despite having falling SpO2. They are having happy hypoxia. So what is the role of HRCT? It represents a valuable tool in identifying patients with COVID-19 infections in a stage when the clinical symptoms may be non-specific or sparse. So in patients who are having a high suspicion of deterioration, we can acquire CT scan. So I'll be coming to that, the clear indications of. So few case scenarios I'll be presenting. This real case scenario is a 65-year-old female, diabetic and hypertensive, poorly controlled, presented to us. And her SpO2 at home was 85% on room air. So the patient started on oxygen support. And when the patient came, there was tachycardia, and the SpO2 was 94%, and she had to be given 10 liters of oxygen. She was classified as a severe category case and admitted in the ICU. Started on the severe category protocol as per the COVID severity criteria. The HRCT, which was done next day, showed multifocal areas of ground glass opacities, and the CT severity score described was 20 out of 25, that is severe. So the patient was also in a clinical severity state, was severe, and the CT scan also showed a severe score. Inflammatory markers were elevated, and IL-6 was also elevated. So we suspected that cytokine storm state has occurred in this patient. During the hospital stay, this patient's clinical condition deteriorated and worsened. The oxygen requirement went up and up, and patient went on HFNC very soon. Then she had inadequate response to the severe category treatment also, and she was given tocilizumab and other treatment which were we used to be giving at that time. But she was put on mechanical ventilator and ultimately succumbed to the complications of severe sepsis, unfortunately. So in such kind of scenarios where we can see that there is a matching picture of the clinical picture as well as the CT scan. So how to utilize this information, I'll be telling later. The case number two was a 50-year-old male, similarly type 2 diabetes on OHAs, presenting with fever and cough and breathlessness, SpO2 80% on room air. This patient was classified as a severe category case on the basis of clinical assessment. You can see the X-ray and the CT scan also shown a severity score of 19 out of 25. So here we can see the ground glass opacities as well as the consolidation patches in almost all the lung fields of this patient in the lung window as well as the mediastinum in the coronal as well as the axial window. So inflammatory markers were also raised in this patient. This patient was also managed on severe category protocols. The clinical severity progressed, oxygen requirement went up and up. He was under care for over a month on HFNC and prone ventilation, and he did well over time. There were times when he was becoming disappointed, but ultimately he responded to the treatment. And then the oxygen was tapered off to a minimum and the RT-PCR report came negative and the patient was referred to a non-COVID center due to persistent oxygen requirement still at the time. So that patient had a severe pneumonia, and he subsequently, even after becoming a COVID negative, he was also having some oxygen requirement. So a few slides about the chest X-ray. What is the role of the chest X-ray in patients' clinical severity assessment and how do they correlate? Most patients with COVID-19 infection have mild illness and do not develop pneumonia. Around 63% of people, the chest X-ray may be normal. Chest X-ray also shows ground glass opacities, coarse horizontal linear opacities and consolidation. And they are more likely to be peripheral and in the lower zones, or maybe in the whole lung zones, depending upon the severity. Bilateral lung involvement is common, but maybe unilateral in 25%. So these are the some X-rays I'll be showing. Ground glass opacities in the lower lobes bilaterally present. Similarly, the later on, initially there are ground glass opacities, and later on consolidation patches are formed, which are more homogeneous opacities. Here in the same patient, the left side, the X-ray on the at an earlier stage, and later on there are patches of consolidation presenting in the same patient. Serial radiological progression is seen in the patients with COVID-19 pneumonia on X-rays. So when we should do CT, what are the CT findings in COVID pneumonia and how do they interpret the radiologists? The chest CT is more specific because it can show, and it shows the presence of ground glass opacities, consolidation, crazy paving pattern, reverse halo sign, vessel engorgement, and architectural distortion and subpleural bands. Some other features which may be some non-specific features may be having some differential diagnosis, nodular pre-in-butt pattern and cavitation may be noted. So they have a definite system of scoring, score 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, from less than 5% involvement to more than 75% involvement in the different lobes. So in the 5 lobes, they add together, and if the score is between 0 to 9, it is taken as a mild disease, 10 to 17 as a moderate, and 18 to 25 as a severe disease. So here we can see the CT score 0, 1, 2. In the from above to below, you can see that the increasing patches of consolidation and GGOs are there, and score 3, 4, and in the 5, score 5, the whole of the lobe is involved. Similarly, in this picture, we can see that in the magnified area, the crazy paving and the consolidation patches are being shown. Some of the evidences that what are the clinical radiological evaluation, what studies have been done on this subject, they show that clinical symptoms of patients directly correlated with the CT severity score. CT imaging was found to be useful in predicting the clinical recovery of the patients or progression of the disease. In this this study, which was done in our own country by Dr. Sudhir Bhandari, this is comparing the clinical and radiological findings. And here we can see that the CT characteristics versus the clinical presentations, they match together in majority of the patients, if not all. The clinical status of patients correlated with the CT severity score, and mild cases showing score less than 15 in 45% patients, whereas severe cases showing CT severity score more than 15 in 87%. So these are the... Yes, I'm concluding. Again, the evidences say that there is a correlation between the clinical severity as well as the radiological severity. The artificial intelligence also has seen the same thing. These are two more cases where I have shown presented these cases who were having known cases of a comorbidities, but they presented in a mild disease as a mild disease, but later on they had some persistent symptoms and later on they deteriorated. And on the HRCT findings, they were found to have moderate disease, like 11 by 25. And they did well on the moderate category protocol of the COVID-19 treatment. And finally, discharged successfully on treatment. So, who should benefit from the CT and what information can be obtained? It is indicated after the clinical evaluation of the patient. CT may be especially helpful in high-risk patients with milder symptoms who have comorbidities such as diabetes, obesity, chronic respiratory disease. It allows the evaluation of disease extent at the baseline, which may help to predict a poor outcome. If supplementary oxygen is needed in patients with limited disease extension, other diagnoses should be considered. Situations where HRCT should not be done. HRCT scan should not be made a routine investigation and should be done for the purpose of diagnosing, should not be done for diagnosing the COVID-19. It is not indicated in persons with asymptomatic COVID. It is not required to initiate the treatment in COVID-19 patients with hypoxia and an abnormal chest radiograph. It is not required to assess the response to treatment. More often, the lung lesions show radiological progression rather than and the clinical, despite the clinical improvement. So the key points are that the CT scans have a pivotal role in assisting physicians in diagnosis and management plan. However, and the CT severity score is positively correlated with inflammatory markers as well as the clinical severity indicators in majority of the patients. But it should not be used as a routine investigation. Nearly two-thirds of asymptomatic patients have abnormal CT findings and do not progress. It should not be done in the first week of the illness. HRCT in asymptomatic patients has a major use in symptomatic patients and comorbid patients with persistent and deteriorating clinical conditions. It is the physician's discretion to customize HRCT decision as per the clinical assessment. And more research is needed to further clarify this issue. So I'm still learning. Learning is continued. Thank you so much for your patient hearing. This is the college where I work.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. And for want of time, I think we'll not have any questions. So.